All right, today, students, we are going to be looking at the urinary system and the reproductive system. And we're first going to be looking at a male fetal pig, and then we'll move to the female pig for the female reproductive system. On this male fetal pig, we're going to start with the urinary system. So, of course, when we're making urine, the blood gets filtered in the kidneys, and then we're going to change that filtrate and modify it until it becomes urine. And so right here, this is that kidney. So here is the right kidney. So this is the right side. This is the left side. This is the right side. So I'm going to get my right kidney and left kidney. So this is my left kidney, and my right kidney is going to be over here on this side. And additionally, there is a tract that extends from the kidney down to the bladder, and that's going to be this tube right here. This is the ureter, and this is actually going to the bladder, which is this structure right here. It doesn't look like a normal bladder because this is a fetal pig. There, the fetal pig is not producing a whole lot of urine. Mom is doing the metabolism, and so the bladder looks very collapsed and kind of elongated. And remember, it's attached in the fetal pig to the umbilicus. On either side of the bladder, we have the umbilical arteries. So remember, these are going to the placenta. They're going away from the fetal heart, and they're going to pick up oxygen and nutrients, and then we're going to, of course, come from the placenta to the umbilical vein, which is the structure here. And we had to transect that to actually retract this tissue here. So as far as the urinary system goes, we have the kidneys. We have the ureter, which you can see is this tube right here, extending down towards the bladder. So I'm going to put a little marker there. And then, of course, we have our urinary bladder, which is going to be this collapsed structure here. And you can identify this by the two umbilical arteries that are on either side. So here, we're just going to put one label through one of the umbilical arteries. I'll probably use this one because it'll be easier. Oh my goodness. Hard to hold it still. So there's my umbilical artery, okay? And then, of course, we have our umbilical vein, which I don't know if I'm gonna be able to put the little thing through, but you'll find this up by the liver. So if you see this little ligament here, this becomes the umbilical ligament, or this becomes a ligament when baby is out of mom, and these will also become ligaments as well. Okay, so right now they're umbilical arteries, umbilical veins, and we have kidney, ureter, and bladder. Hello, students. Today we're going to be talking about the reproductive system. We're going to start with a male fetal pig, and we know this is a male because, one, we can actually see the sheath here. So there's an opening right here, and the penis is inside of that sheath. And remember, on a lot of our mammals, this is a protective covering to prevent trauma to the penis. If you turn this retracted tissue over, you can actually see the penis within that sheath. So I've kind of dissected this out a little bit. So this is actually the penis. Here's my bladder. Here's my umbilical arteries for orientation. So this right here is the penis, and this will come in, curve around. It contains the urethra, and that will go to the bladder. Additionally, if you look externally, we have a sac out here which will hold the testes. We've cut into that sac to remove the left testicle, but you can appreciate the testes will sit out in this sac. And here we've actually dissected out the spermatic cord, so we can see the spermatic cord, which contains the vas deferens and the vessels and the connective tissue going to the testes. This is the left testis here, and you can see the epididymis right here. And then, of course, we have the vas deferens that comes in. So when you first look at your male, open up the abdomen, and you see this, these two structures looping here over the bladder, you know you have a male because these are the vas deferens, and these are going into the inguinal canal and out to the scrotum out here. All right, so now that we've gone through these structures, we're gonna go ahead and label them. So again, remember, for the penis, we're gonna look for the sheath here, and we can see that opening. So I'll grab that and we can label that. So this right here is the actual sheath, and the penis is within there. I'm gonna have to kind of retract this to the side, and I can actually see the penis itself, which is right there. So this structure, this tubular structure right here, this is the actual penis, okay? And as for the testicle, we have the left testicle over here. We've dissected out, and this right here will be the testicle. And we have the epididymis. I don't have a pin for that because it's so small and it's hard to kind of separate that out. But this right here is the epididymis. And if we look at the vas deferens, the best place to see this, again, is when we're looping over the bladder. This is a great area to see the vas deferens right there. Okay. And if we were to talk about the spermatic cord, this again is going to be this entire structure with vas deferens and the vessels going out to the testes. So that would be our spermatic cord. Hello, students. Today we're going to look at the female fetal pig. And so for reproductive structures to look externally, we're going to look at the umbilicus. And caudal to that, we should see a sheath if this is a male. So no sheath, no opening. This is nice and flat. So this should be a female. We're going to confirm that by looking at the posterior end or the caudal end of the fetal pig. And we can see this little flap right here. And this is actually the vulva. So we can see the opening right here to the female reproductive tract. So that determines that we have a female. I'm going to go ahead and retract this umbilical tissue here. And just to orient ourselves, we have the bladder right here. Remember, it's collapsed because this is a fetal pig. We have umbilical arteries here. And so remember in the male, we talked about looking at this area and you should see one little cord going this way and one cord going that way. We don't necessarily see that here. We've got something a little different. So when we look here, we actually have these like little curly structures here. And if we look to the edge, this structure right here is actually the female ovary. So that little glandular tissue right there is the female ovary. These curly structures right here, that is uterine horn. So remember, this is different than in the human female. We have a bicornate uterus in the fetal pig or in pigs. And so that means we actually have horns, and this horn is elongated here to allow for multiple babies. So they each have an efficient amount of placental contact to survive. So here we have our right horn. This is going to be the left horn. We have the right ovary here. You can kind of, if you look very closely, you can see a connection between the uterine horn and the ovary, and that will be the oviduct. I'm not going to pin that because it's very small and it's hard to see. And then of course we can look on the left side, and again we can see the ovary right here, and again we've got the uterine horn, and this will come together into the uterine body and then go out into the urogenital sinus or vestibule, and then of course out the vulva there. So the vagina empties into that sinus. We can't see the vagina here. So for labeling, we'll label our external structure here first. This is our vulva, so right there. And then if we come in here, we're going to label the uterus, which are these long horns here. So in general, this would be called uterus, but specifically, this would also be the uterine horn. So this long tubular structure, you can use both names for it. And remember, this is different than in the human female, where we have a simplex uterus, which is just rounded. Additionally, we've got our ovaries here. This is going to be our right ovary right here, that little structure. You can see that. Oops. There's our right ovary, and of course, our left ovary there. So, and again, this is different than the male. You'll see these curly structures if it's female. The male just has a looping over of the vas deferens and extends caudally.